into the future. Good morning. Good into the good. 120 minutes.
Lewis Largent with you here for 120 minutes on MTV. We're here each and every Sunday night at midnight, 11 Central. And tonight we got two members of a very cool band out of New York City that hopefully we can turn you on to. They have just an EP out, and they're called Luscious Jackson. They're here for an interview. We also got an exclusive, never-before-seen live performance from the Violent Femmes. Also rolling out new, brand new video for a cult classic song by Lou Reed's old band, The Velvet Underground. Plus, we got brand new ones from Verve, The Spinanes, Rancid, and Black Market Flowers. The latest from Urge Overkill, One Dove, Concrete Blonde, Juliana Hatfield III, The Buzzcocks, Depeche Mode, Catherine Wheel, and more. We're going to kick things off with James in the video for the title track to their fifth album, Laid.
Everything we do is through improvisation. I mean, just people messing around.
I mean, we tried sitting down and being a bit more kind of like, you know, working like proper musicians do, you know, but we kind of don't do it very well.
We don't know how to behave like that.
No, we don't.
Daughters of the Kaos in the house of God, living with my six guns, and I move along like a gangster, keeping the family strong with the mission of chaotic song. Of the chaos, semi-automatic sisters, I might be strong, but don't call me mister. Playing with the status quo of the soul, enjoy Babylon, chaos, chaos.
Welcome back to MTV's 120 Minutes, and now I am joined by two members of Luscious Jackson, bass player and singer Jill Kniff, who is to my right, and Gabby Glaser, who is the guitarist and also singer. And your EP, you have a debut EP out called In Search of Manny, which is on the Beastie Boys Grand Royale label, which is, I believe, the first release of that fine label.
That's right. It's Grand Royal.
It's spelled...
People have been saying Royale. Even though there's no E on the end of it,
it's
just a thing people do.
what is your connection with the brothers Beastie?
We've been friends with them for so long that I can't remember when we met them. Probably like 10 years ago or something. And
what were they all doing? Like, what were all you guys
we
doing 10 years
like
ago?
We were all like high school students in New York City, and just going out to see bands play and going to clubs and
we going dancing every
yeah,
night.
Going out, staying. We were night crawlers.
And
underage night crawlers.
And then they get, I guess, were you guys a band at that point? Were you in bands at that point?
I used to play with them, and
I had a guitar, and I played in my room, but...
Now, they did use instruments in their first incarnation
of
the band?
Yeah, I was in a band with them called the Young Aborigines, and it was really like a Public Image ripoff. Pretty much.
No, I heard your drummer was also.
Kate Schellenbach, our drummer, was in the Beastie Boys for the first two records, so.
So she's like the Pete Best of the Beastie Boys.
I guess so, yeah.
But hopefully it'll all turn out.
Well, now she's a Luscious Jackson, so.
Now, Luscious Jackson sounds like a lounge singer or something like that, like a 50s blues singer or something. Where did the name come from?
I was looking through my brother's sports trivia book, and there was the name, and he was a basketball player, Luscious Jackson, in the 60s. So it was just a really cool name, we thought. And since then, we've, you know, it's taken on all kinds of new connotations, which we didn't think about, so.
We're going to watch the first video from the EP, Daughters of the Kaos. Who are the Daughters of the Kaos? Is that you, or is it...
It's a fictional fantasy army of women who take back the planet.
And watch it now. Daughters of the Kaos from Luscious Jackson here on MTV's 120 Minutes.
Semi-automatic sisters, I might be strong, but don't call me mister. Playing with the status quo the soul. Enjoy Babylon, chaos, KO. Chaos making history, always give shelter to a man in need. In the face of chaos, I give up my greed. Insane and unknown is my only creed. The joy destroy, then set you free.
Luscious Jackson there with Daughters of the Kaos here in 120 Minutes. And quite coincidentally, Jill and Gabby, two-fourths of Luscious Jackson, are here. Their debut EP, In Search of Manny, is out. Who is Manny, and have you found him yet?
Gabby, you want to answer that?
Sure. Manny was my mother's boyfriend a long time ago. And she used to take these crazy pictures of him, and that's one of them.
Half nude.
Yeah, just, you know,
in underwear.
A fun couple thing to do, I guess. And we were looking for a cover art, and we just thought that this would be kind of a good idea, and
it was, like, really symbolic to us of our music. We felt like Manny was the personification of our music.
And
his style,
easygoing, laid back, just...
His look, his savoir-faire.
Is your mom okay with, like, she's...
I asked her permission, and she said, sure, go ahead.
And she was pretty excited about it, I think, actually.
She was like, oh, you're crazy. Okay, go ahead. You know.
Is Manny okay with it, or does he just not care because that's like...
I don't know where
we
he
really
is.
Don't
I'd
know.
Love to see him. He was really awesome. I'd love to get in touch
Manny
with
was the guy who, like, turned Gabby on to all kinds of music.
Yeah.
Like, what music did he turn you on to?
Well, let's see, back then, soul music in the 70s and the Rolling Stones. I mean, you know, back when it was coming out, like, 74 would be, like...
Sly and the Family Stone.
Sly and the Family Stone.
Stevie Wonder.
Inner Visions. I don't know.
No, Jose Feliciano.
Jose Feliciano.
Covering
the
gamut.
You know, he just played great music in the house. So it was really inspiration.
I was looking on the CD, and you have copyrights from 1993, or 92 and 93. Are these old songs that have been lying around for a while?
91, yeah.
91 and 92. I think the story of our EP is very long and drawn out, you know.
Should we save that for the...
The third segment?
Yes.
Sure.
Okay. You'll hear that story momentarily, more with Jill and Gabby from Luscious Jackson in the second 60 of MTV's 120 Minutes.
Into the future. Good morning. 120 minutes.
Lewis Largent, along with Luscious Jackson, going into the second 60 of MTV's 120 Minutes. We're here each and every Sunday night at midnight, 11 Central. Next hour, more conversation with Jill and Gabby, plus videos from Verve, Dig, Rancid, The Buzzcocks, Black Market Flowers, Depeche Mode, Catherine Wheel, Flop, and a whole lots more. We're going to kick things off with an exclusive, never-before-seen live performance by the Violent Femmes, who stopped by 120 in October and played a few songs, one of which was Blister in the Sun, which we already played for you just barely. We got in the biggest trouble because we go, here they are, the Violent Femmes, and due to some technical mix-up, we didn't play it, and I don't think that we've ever gotten more hate letters for a screw-up than we did when we did that. So here it is, cross our fingers, hopefully the Violent Femmes from their new Greatest Hits package. Here is Kiss Off. From their self-titled debut album, that's Dig, with their new video, Believe, here on 120 Minutes. I'm Lewis Largent. Jill and Gabby from Luscious Jackson are here, and you were going to start a long story that was too long for the last segment about your EP, In Search of Manny.
Our EP, In Search of Manny. The story is, Gabby and I got together. We made our demo tape. The first three songs are the EP, the first three songs on the EP, one of which is Daughters of the Kaos. So that song, which is on MTV now, was actually done with our pocket money, you know.
That was the first song we did,
Yeah. And we produced it ourselves and with Tony Mangurian, who we still work with. And, you know, we sent the tape to a few select people, one of whom was Mike D from the Beastie Boys. And he said he really was into the tape and he wanted to start a label and would we be the first band. So we were like, cool, excellent, you know, this is our friend, let's do it. And then it took, like, so long to get the record out.
Why did it take long? What happened?
I think you have to call Mike about that. I'm not really sure. I think he was
touring. It was the beginning of his own label as well, so everything
was new.
Yeah,
he was touring. I mean, I'd call him and not hear back from him for like a week, you know, because he'd be on the road. So their record had just come out, and they were just working. Finally, it came out. We did a few more songs, and the finished product hit the market, you know, finally.
You guys have such an amazing sound. I'm just like, I can't really, it's good to not even be able to categorize you guys. Where does it may be a difficult question to ask or to answer. Where does it come from? It's like kind
our
of
inner soul.
It's kind of hip hop, it's rock, it's like dancey, it's like you have, do you use a lot of samples and things like that, or sample drum beats?
Yeah, when we did the record, we didn't have much money and we didn't have a live drummer either, so we would just play a couple of the songs we play live instruments over the drum loop, and then other ones we just use all different kinds of samples. We'll take a sample and like program to the keyboard and change it.
Now, is it you guys that are doing all this, or is it a producer?
Us. We have an engineer co-producer, Tony.
Yeah, who's awesome. I mean, he's.
How much of it do you use in your live show? Because I got to be honest with you, when I heard the record and then I want to see you live, sometimes it doesn't translate live, but you guys are really good live. How much of it is, do you use any of that, like pre-recorded stuff
when
you play live?
Yeah. It's a tricky thing to do when you are a studio band initially and you have to bring it out there and perform live. So I think it's like still an evolutionary process where we figure out what we need, and you know, I think we're getting a DJ. So Vivian triggers some samples from her keyboard, and then we'll have a DJ who can also.
And Kate will just play the drum beat. Like for this song, actually, it's a sampled drum beat, but live she plays the drums.
Now, when's a proper album going to come out? The EP is out. It's great. 7 songs. Good deal for your money if you get it cheap. But when's a proper album? And what are your tour plans?
Like album.
April,
yes.
Right?
April. I would say yeah.
We just got off tour with the Breeders in Europe and in Canada, and
here, America.
Right, a couple days in America.
Days, yeah.
And so now we're just focusing on doing the record, finishing it. And not touring for a little while.
So probably we'll tour in May or something.
Well, thanks for coming by, you guys. It's a terrific EP, and glad you stopped by, and good luck in the future.
Thank you.
Okay, and we're going to play a video from Verve off their debut album, Storm in Heaven. This is called Blue.